Have you been enjoying yourself so far?
Yes, I mean, stupendously. I've had a lot of fun, and people asking me very rude questions about me. No, it's been a lovely day, lovely day.
You've been part of some fantastic films on the big screen. We've just celebrated a special anniversary for Willow. Why do you think that's a film that people still love all these years later all around the world so much?
Well, Willow and Return to Oz are very similar in the way that they're very powerful and they're very moving as well. They're not just awful witches, which I mean, I play awful witches. So I think that they're human. That's what it is.
I mean, talking about your characters, obviously you're very nice in real life, but in those films in particular, you were terrifying. Can you talk a little bit about Bavmorda and, of course, Mombi as well?
Well, those two, I've played absolutely vile, vile thing. I mean, some things that aren't put in there when I almost ate a baby or something. And it was terrible, terrible. But there was always a reason. There was I was an evil person who could also either be sort of get better, but also could get out of the way. It's fun. I know playing evil people is great fun, but especially in films as witches, you know they're not real, so you get terrified and then you think, oh no, it's all right.
Fans will have their favourite moments from those films, their favourite scenes. Are there any looking back now that you have a particular fondness for, either because of memories on set or just when you see the end product?
I think I like very much when I had heads crewed onto my head and I screwed them. And I did think, oh, how wonderful. I'd like that over there, that beautiful girl, instead of me. So I like that sort of thing. But I don't remember it all because it was all so big and so busy and so much going on. And of course, it's a long time ago, so I don't really know.
Upstairs, Downstairs, obviously a series that, again, has a very special place in people's hearts. Why do you think people still have so much affection for that show?
Well, Upstairs, Downstairs, the first one, worked very well because it had never been done before that you had people who were downstairs people. You didn't have normal people being working class people. So, and to have the whole downstairs be as just as important as upstairs. That's why people enjoyed it. I mean, not just rich people, that they were interested in it because finally we downstairs people were involved.
Of course, I mean, the nation's still fascinated with period drama, Downton Abbey. I mean, what do you think it is about particularly that period of history, that those kind of social structures that seem to fascinate people so?
It's partly because it's near enough that you can remember. I mean, of course, for me, I can go further back. But what works on film or television is if you can relate to the past, but not too far back. It doesn't work as well in 1710. You know, that's what happens.
Of course, you mentioned Doctor Who. I mean, it's a big question, but what do you think is the magic of Doctor Who? Why does that endure so much, and why is it the most beloved, arguably, sci-fi show in the world?
I don't know. I've actually never seen it in my life. I've done 3 episodes. I've enjoyed it enormously. It's I don't know. One of these days I'll watch some because they're wonderful actors in it. But I think it's because I'm out cooking or out. One of those things, it just doesn't figure out with me.
For young people watching this who'd love to follow in your luminous footsteps, what advice would you give them about becoming an actor, an actress themselves?
Get out of the business. I love the fact that people love me playing the evil people, and that pleases me enormously. And then when I see people in the street and they go, ah, how awful, and then you think, oh no, she's nice.